As the United States rapidly approaches the 100,000 death grim milestone from COVID-19, doctors across the country are joining together to ask the American Hospital Association, one of the largest healthcare trade groups in this country, to stop funneling dark money into the fight against Medicare for All and instead maybe use that money to protect both patients and frontline healthcare workers. Now, isn't that a remarkable idea? Because we're in the middle of a global pandemic, and the AHA is still pouring millions of dollars into the fight against Medicare for All, even though there's no candidates left running for president who support Medicare for All anymore. And it's very unlikely that any of the vice presidential candidates are going to support Medicare for All. And yet this organization is so desperate to preserve their own profits that they are paying millions of dollars for this fight, funneling this dark money into these super PACs and other lobbyist organizations to fight Medicare for All instead of buying equipment for their hospitals, taking care of their doctors and nurses, giving staffs raises. They would rather protect their own profits while letting their healthcare professionals die than have to, I don't know, do their jobs. But that is according to 23,000 doctors who came together this week to call on the organization to stop with the lobbying, stop with the dark money, and start focusing that money on the hospitals themselves. And this is actually something that applies not just during a pandemic to the hospital industry. It applies to the hospital industry for the entire year, for every day, for always and forever. Just like it applies to the fossil fuel companies who don't want to spend a few million dollars making their plants cleaner. So instead they spend a few million dollars on lobbyists to argue that they shouldn't have to make their plants cleaner. It makes no sense, folks. The whole lobbying thing. Because a lot of the things that these businesses, these major corporations lobby for, it costs them just as much to lobby for them as it would to just go ahead and comply with a new regulation or to just make the changes that they need to make to take care of their people. But they don't see it that way, right? They see it as, well, we'd have to pay this money for years and years and years. So in the long run, in the short run, it's going to cost us more to comply than it would for the lobbyists. But the problem is compliance is a one-time cost. Lobbyists are a year-round expense every year. You're paying those same people every year to go back and fight because those compliance issues come back up, right? You killed that regulation, well, somebody's just going to bring it up again. Now you got to fight it again. Wouldn't it be cheaper to comply? Same thing with the hospital corporations. You're seeing the death tolls in your hospitals increase. You're seeing the number of sick doctors and nurses and other staffers increase. Wouldn't it be within your best interest, instead of having to, you know, pay for the sick leave of these folks or the potential lawsuits from these folks, wouldn't it be cheaper to just go ahead and maybe take a month or two off the dark money thing and put that into protecting these workers? The answer is yes. It would make more sense. It would be more compassionate. But common sense and compassion have absolutely no place, unfortunately, in the American capitalistic system.